Faden, Luigi Octavo, Trent Fusion, a bunch of guys have won the Daytona 500 here for the Jello Cup Series. One guy today will add his name to that list. Hello and welcome here to the Daytona International Raceway. This is the Jello Cup Series Daytona 500, the fourth annual running of the event. I'm Brian James. I'm proud to bring you coverage of this race. And today, joining me again is Daniel Hummel.
Hi guys, what's up?
Yeah, he couldn't get enough of the series after the, I think, kind of exciting Carvana wildcard series event.
Yeah, definitely interesting. I like these restrictor plate races.
Yeah, no, I hope we'll see a little bit of the same today. We saw some exciting dual races. We saw a little bit of drama in the practices, but it's all led up to this moment. Tell me about the moment. How big is it for these drivers?
Daytona 500, your name etched on that trophy. Some life-changing stuff right here.
Yeah, and not to mention the big purse can help any team in this field. And one team that ran really well in the Gander RV duel was the 52 of Damian Blue. He won that duel in the Rick Ware Racing Chevrolet.
That's amazing.
So I gotta imagine that's a huge confidence boost for this team entering the 500.
Oh, absolutely.
And unfortunately, the bad news: Trent Fusion and Luigi Octavo, two former winners, are not in the field today. We do have Eric Faden, though. Is he a viable threat to win his second Daytona 500?
I think everyone's a viable threat to win the Daytona 500. I mean, it definitely brings confidence to you, experience. You know how to run this track.
Yeah. And the big thing is, looking at this grid, starting on the pole, the ride he won the Daytona 500 in back in Season 1, that 48 of Audra Baranoskis. You know, Hummel, you were here for that Daytona 500 that Eric Faden won. Unfortunately, our commentary was not heard because of my computer having the issues that it had. So, who knows, maybe we'll see a little bit of a repeat today, maybe some deja vu.
Maybe.
Anyway, without further delay to getting the proceedings going, let's get the command.
Drivers, start your engines!
Very enthusiastic as we get going. These guys will take their pace laps. And we will be right back with your starting lineup in just a few moments here on Indiana to watch the cars roll out. Here we go. You see them rolling. The starting grid is on the left-hand side of your screen, as it has been to this point. Do you know anyone you're keeping an eye on?
No one in particular. I'm just hoping for an exciting race here.
Yeah. I'll tell you who I have an eye on. That number 93 of Ricky Johnson. He won the Carvana race here.
Definitely knows how to run track, Talladega and Daytona.
Yeah, and it's not just that. He won the Carvana race. He almost won at season finale. The 12 is blown up. Daniel, your call.
And we're green here at the Daytona 500.
I got a little pressed for time there, but you saw the 12 blow up, and that is Jacob Dillon's in the number 12. Not the way to start the 500. And you got to feel for them, because they've gone a week and a half through speed weeks, and to have that happen to end your chance at the 500, that's got to sting.
It does. It really hurts, yeah.
And unfortunately, mechanical issues you can't prevent. For the 2 and the 22, are you worried now? Because this is an engine. This is a Team Penske car.
You know, I try and look past it. Hopefully it doesn't happen to me if I'm in that position.
But you have that slight bit of concern.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then, you know, you have it in the back of your head that this could happen as Kevin McHugh leads the opening lap.
Oh, there's contact behind them.
The 18s on the apron that throw them are on. But, and then another guy who needs to keep an eye out is that number 21. He is a part of that engine deal with Team Penske. So the 21, should he be concerned as well?
52 for the lead.
Is 52 go for the lead? Oh, they're wrecking.
The 88th around into the wall hard. Rear end into the wall.
Oh, the big one at Daytona.
Upside down, 23. One guy, 48 upside down. Oh boy, we have a mess in turn four.
Well, Daniel, we forgot to account for the big one to this point. You see the 17 major
rear end of that 88 is destroyed.
Oh, that hurts. And I forgot to put that up at the beginning. The 12 is on the race, a camshaft issue, as you just saw on the scrolling ticker.
They've got a mess down in turn four.
And, oh my gosh. You know, I'm telling you, in the Carvana series in here, we never accounted for the big one.
No, we didn't.
We completely let that slip our minds. We apologize for that. But we're going to go see what happened. Based on my watch, Daniel, I'd have to say that the 2 got out of line, and just the 48 did not lift, possibly. Yeah, that's a clear hook right there.
Unfortunately, the 88 and the 34 just got, had nowhere to go. They didn't even see it coming.
And this blocked up the whole track here.
You see
the 2 doesn't get much damage.
When you see wrecks like that in the turns, you know it's going to be huge.
And Ricky Johnson, the winner the other day, here, the winner last weekend here.
And look at this one, and the 47 just goes right underneath the 23.
Oh man, that is a tough break for all these guys.
Hits that banking, just rolls right over.
And the 23 is on top of the 52.
And our car set on too, looks like. And up there, that's...
That's the 18 Frodo-Marat. That is a tough break all around. We're going to get the total count of cars out of the race in just a moment, but let's take you back to the green. Here we go. They got the one to go. Boy, that is a long count.
Shoot.
Oh, pause the frames for a second there. That's wonderful.
Yeah,
technical difficulties, guys. So the 42 Austin Shaw is out of the race. He's one of the guys. Look at that count right there. Over 10 cars retired from the race after that wreck.
Well, 9, 12 is already out. But
so we're going to go through your top 10 after that chaotic lap number 2 wreck. Joshua Piccoli is your race leader. Steve Morgan in second. Dick Clark in third. Mitchell Collins in fourth, Kevin Q fifth,
Jonathan Drain in sixth, Andrew Wilson seventh, Ricky Logan eighth, Charles Sanford ninth, and Richard Kinghart tenth. As we go back green here at Daytona.
Here we go, guys. The 13 looking on the inside. They're already going double wide. We're not seeing much of the manufacturers working together like we normally see.
At least not like we did in the Carvana series.
Yeah, there's really, even still, like in that series, we didn't see it as much. There's really no manufacturer alliances going on right here. It's more just push the guy ahead of you.
Three wide for the lead. 22's right in the sucker hole right there.
And that 11 of Kevin McHugh back to the race lead.
Left out to dry in the top line.
Yep, and now here comes double zero. That is Jonathan Rain. Did he lead the lap? No! The 11. That was a close battle there. And you see the 8 is in the thick of it. Keep an eye on him. That's the former Daytona 500 winner. Back from season 1.
Lock bumper. Whole top 10 is lock bumper.
and surprising to see them racing so aggressive this early on. Yeah, and
where'd that 37 come from?
Yeah, Ricky Logan came from about, I think, the middle of the pack. Right there. And he's now in the thick of things. Same with Charles Sanford.
The power of Daytona.
Charles Sanford. Always a bridesmaid, but never the bride.
This lead group is starting to pull away.
And look at that, Patrick Smith to the race lead. He made the Daytona 500 on a last lap pass in the Gander RV duel with Daytona for JBM. Oh boy, three wide. See the eights in the wall.
Oh,
and around they go.
Around goes the 37 and the 8. Oh boy, right in the middle of the pack. This isn't gonna be good.
No, it's not. The 8 might not have... As I spoke. He's gonna have some sort of engine damage out of that. Ouch.
I'm getting to the wall and I'm like,
oh man, we almost got through that. Let's go see what happened. Yeah, it's just super hard to run three wide here. See that? The 8's just pushed by the 24, and around they go.
50 feet, barely gets
2 saves it. 37 sustains a lot of damage. Oh, and the 51 got a piece of the 8.
It looks like the 8 would have been fine until he ran into the 14 right over here.
Yeah, you see here, he just...
That's a hard hit.
I think he misjudged it. He misjudged that spatial thing.
Now I think he has some sort of engine problem. That's not good in the car.
Yeah, we'll have to wait and see. We'll take you back to the green though in just a moment. Well, we got the one to go, and Daniel, so much for a second Daytona 500.
Yep, Eric Faden is out of the race, unfortunately.
Yeah, and we kind of called this one after he hit the car on the apron. There, anyway, it's Patrick Smith for JBM leading the race. Then you got the Chip Ganassi car of Andrew Wilson in second, Henry Williams in third, Bob Wirth is fourth, and Casey Nonaco is fifth.
We got Steve Morgan sixth, we got Joshua Spicoli seventh, Mitch Collins eighth, Angel Navarro 9th, and Jonathan Rain 10th as we get ready to go at green.
Yep, and the question is, how many cars have not been damaged? This has turned into a survival of the fittest. If we go back green here at Daytona.
21 laps to go. Long way to go. We're not even halfway through.
Not even halfway through. Almost half the field is out of the race right now. How about the guy who had to qualify his way into the 500, leading the event?
Where he came from.
And then Bob Wirth back there, another one of those go-or-go-homers, hoping to capitalize and get some points today.
Kind of fighting for the inside, and 55 to make it around the cover, probably.
Now here comes 13, that is Steve Morgan.
3 wide per second.
They still haven't learned.
They're racing really aggressive.
Yeah, see there, it's mainly single file now. Boy, the 22's right up on the rear end.
You gotta be careful, you're gonna turn the 13 to do that.
These are not straight bumpers, so... You push a car, it's not gonna go over very well. And the defending Daytona 500 winning team is on the inside pushing the 22. That is Casey Nonaco. He did not win the Daytona 500 last season as he's a rookie making his debut, but this team won it last season. Hoping to repeat as Mitchell Collins goes to the race lead. can see here a lot of guys being able to stick with the main group. How is the lap traffic, though, going to impact this?
We'll slow them down a little bit.
Maybe break up the lead pack. That's a possibility that they got to be ready for in the 22. That's a little too far out to get.
You can't really get that far out by yourself. Unless you have, like, a great draft.
Somehow he's maintaining that gap.
21 seconds.
And he's got a row of Fords behind him. No, no pit stops. And straight green to the finish.
Oh,
up ahead. Just as we mentioned it. The 14 of Dick
he's
Clark.
Really slow. He's 40 miles an hour under the pace. Look out!
Oh, there they go. But do they save it?
Around. I don't think it's a caution, though.
He's just spinning, and he saves it.
Is there a caution? Yep, the caution's out.
Wow. Caution is out for the 11.
He was off
of
the
Kevin
track.
McHugh. He didn't sustain any damage, it doesn't look like, so he'll be able to continue.
Oh, that lap traffic sometimes.
Oh, man, you can imagine he's going to have a few words for Dick Clark after this race. Because now he's going to be stuck behind the guys with damage to the engine. Anyway, let's go see what happens. You know, that lap traffic, always a factor here at Daytona. Oh, he hit the rear end of the 14.
No,
he
just couldn't. I got right into the double zero there.
Double zero pulled a little bit of a Jacques Villeneuve there. Just said, I don't care if you're in front of me. I'm spinning you.
I'm saving myself before I save you.
Yeah. But luckily, thanks to getting rid of most of the grass, the 11 will not hit any of the walls. That's a lucky break for them. And they'll be able to continue, hopefully get back up to the front.
Still plenty of time left, too. We're still not even halfway through this race. Plenty of time to get back up there.
We will have to wait and see if we'll take you back to the green here at Daytona. Guess what? We lost track of the timing. We're back green. Time flies when you're having fun, I guess. And now we are past the halfway mark of the race.
This race is official, as CW would say. And much joy.
Yeah, let's take a look there. Only 25 cars left in this race. Okay, now out of the 40 that started,
we might have half the field out of this race by the end of this one, the way we're going.
See there, Kevin McHugh having a lot of ground to make up. He's coming 65 now with help from the 21. How patient is that 11 going to be? As we're going to flip cameras real quick. How patient do you be going through half of these cars ahead of you with a ton of damage? I mean, it's halfway. You're coming up on 10 to go very soon. That's the problem as well. You don't want to lose the draft. And then the other problem is the guys behind them are slow, so it's not really... He's in a tough situation.
He's going to have to hope for at least another caution. Which I'm sure we'll probably get the way we're going.
Yeah. I wouldn't question it at this point. He's 65 up high.
That wall.
But it's a little bit more spread out now, so it shouldn't cause a wreck. The 22 of Mitchell Collins hanging on to the lead. This is a double playoff point race, so leading the most laps gets you 2 playoff points, and a win will get you 10. So a lot at stake here right now.
Starting to single out over here.
And just as you said that,
there goes the 9 to the inside.
He doesn't have drafting help though, so it's not gonna do anything. Maybe just trying to get some clean air.
The 62 is kind of sneak into that inside liner.
Yeah, at 62, Joshua Sicali, the longtime driver over at Richard Childress Racing. He was, him and Hillary Sanchez, the odd drivers out this season as they downsized to a two-car program. And RCR said, you know what, we're helping Beard Motorsports this season. How's about a ride over there? And Joshua Sicali, still a part of the RCR camp, just not by affiliation. That makes Dylan Young the only driver, aside from Angel Navarro, who has remained with the same team their entire Cup Series career. Talk about dedication there.
Oh, meanwhile, we have like an 8-car breakaway up front. Now the top 5 is starting to push away.
Yeah, they're starting to get single file, and look back there.
They won't.
Oh, went a little bit ahead of myself there, but Charles Sanford just barely hanging on to the tail end of that draft. Same for Joshua Sicali.
I think he just threw a short end right there.
Joshua Sicali might have lost it too there.
Maybe a 7-car breakaway. Why do they keep bunching up like that?
I can see it.
Ever wonder why NASCAR drivers go single file around the track? It's the fastest way around. May not be the most interesting way, but...
Yeah, without question there. Here comes the 65 now. He's got help from the 13. We're coming up on 10 to go. Is this the point where you're picking your partner and saying, you know, look, let's get this done? Yeah, knowing that this is a breakaway, this is a good chance to find a partner. And could the 22 be left out to dry?
That's a good job you're driving, I guess. Yeah. I think it's a little too early for that.
I mean, the 21 was his partner who got him the race lead. So that's why I only suggest
one
that maybe...
One the 65 on the dry.
But the other thing to factor in, you look a little ways ahead in the turn one. You got the 2 of Dylan Young and the 88 of William Brock. Both heavily damaged race cars.
30 miles an hour.
And the 22 is blocking, not good enough. Here, Steve Morgan to the race lead. You see they've lost the 62.
He's way out of that.
This is now a 7-car breakaway for the race lead.
Still going 3 wide over here. 22 at...
Oh, boy, here we go again.
3x3. Oh, boy.
They keep it together.
Are they looking to go 4 wide here?
No, they're not. They're staying smart as Andrew Wilson, the lead. Look ahead, though.
They're both catching by the back stretch.
They're starting to catch the back end of the pack.
I'm hoping they get by this cleanly. And...
Oh, they have to slow down a little bit. 65's hung up. 65 is held up. The 2, the 1, and the 10.
Oh, he's right on the bumper.
The 1 just used the 10. Or, the 1 just used the 2 as a pick.
And he is really slowing down that pack.
And now Dylan Young moves to the high side.
That helped Andrew Wilson a ton.
It hurt him, too. Look at these guys
now
to the inside. They are all formed up, and he doesn't have a draft ahead. But then they also got the 93 of Ricky Johnson to watch out for. Yeah. That's the best part of being a single car right there.
Oh, it's an R. He's on an R pack right there.
Yeah. Looking back, though.
There's contact behind them. All I thought
was a right. They almost spun each other out. The 9 got a little frustrated there. As a rookie, you got to keep your composure. The 9 almost spun the veteran Tim Randolph with damage.
Now they have have no one in front of them.
I'm sure the 11 would have loved to see that. Ricky Johnson won't be a factor for at least another couple laps.
Lap and a half, maybe. Lap.
Well, let's see here. Look at the mile per hour difference. 5 miles an hour faster for the 65.
They're back.
Is he going to give him a nudge and say, hey,
right
behind you. We're coming to 5 laps of racing to go.
I think he found his dance partner.
Right along with the 65 here, the Wegmans on board. And you're right, not too far from now. Let's go up a car ahead and take a look at the rear view camera. Look at that, there's like a little air bubble right there. Oh, he's hung up.
Oh boy. That kiss isn't going to end well.
Oh, boy. 13 was not going to have that.
And now, you got 2 cars ahead of them.
3 cars ahead.
That's not going to last long, though.
Yeah. 4 laps to go. Patrick Smith.
Second ahead of 13.
And look who's in that lead pack again. Joshua Sicully is back in the lead pack.
All these lap traffic cars help them out a ton.
Debbie's right back in the thick of things. Back behind them, though. There's a whole second pack going.
They
saved it. And look at these guys, they've gotten reformed, and they're at least 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than your race leader right now.
I was hoping that that one car would go around. We're probably almost be close to ending this race.
We'd have a late race restart for sure, and that would create chaos. We get a caution now, there's no doubt the race is over. As here we go, battle for the lead again.
Basically,
Steve Morgan. Here we go.
It's gonna get intense now.
You've picked your partner at this point. Whoever's in front of you, you're pushing to the finish.
Yeah, more lap traffic ahead. The 10.
And the 9's down low. An issue for the 9 car.
I think you just try to avoid the 10. He went down there to avoid the 10.
Could be. He's back up on the track again with 2 to go.
Oh, the 10's losing the draft.
Bob Worth, that is a tough break for them. They've had a great run here through Speed Week.
You have to hope for that lap traffic up ahead.
And they're catching them. This is going to be a last lap impact. You know, I think it's going to be whoever gets through this lap traffic the quickest is going
to
win the race.
I think they're going to make the impact big backstretch. Maybe turn one at this race.
Oh, boy. You know what's going to happen. If Andrew Wilson wins this race, he's going to be thanking the lap traffic with 1 to go.
He doesn't win the race, he's going to be blaming the lap traffic
with
1 to go.
Yep. You're either going to be blaming them or thanking them. And the worst part is they're double wide. Caution is out. But is it after they took the white flag?
I think it's after, because they're still speeding up. So this is the race for the finish right here.
Oh, backstretch, a wreck, the 2.
The 2 and the 88, maybe? So this is race for the win.
Oh,
right here.
Boy, to the inside.
Oh, this is going to be interesting right here.
The 51 is not slow right now. Out of turn 4.
That's going to be a formal finish right here.
No, it's not. That doesn't look like it. Andrew Wilson wins the Daytona 500. Told you, he's going to be thanking the lap traffic, or he's going to be blaming them.
In this case, he's thanking them.
Yes, Andrew Wilson Daytona 500 winner for Chip Ganassi Racing.
Rookie, too.
Rookie in his debut. I believe that makes it three seasons in a row that a rookie has won the Daytona 500. Before we show you the results, let's go see what happened with Dylan Young and William Brock. Daniel, I think there's going to be a posting for a new job as a spotter of the 2 car after this race.
He just tried to go up there and didn't see him, I guess.
Yeah.
The spotter didn't see him coming or something.
Either that or there's going to be a posting for the 77 spotter, one of the two. Both spotters at fault here, maybe.
Unfortunate.
And that's a tough break for Dylan Young. Tough way to end the race. Congratulations, though, to Andrew Wilson, the Daytona 500 winner. And we're going to show you your results and your standings in just a moment. Keep in mind, some drivers did get a bonus from the Gander RV duel, so they got a few more points than you would normally see. So just a heads up on that. Anyway, we want to thank you for watching. Daniel, thank you for joining. Once again, watch out for signups for the Pepsi Hybrid series. That should be coming real soon. And once again, thank you for joining me here. And we'll see you at Atlanta for the Bolt of Honor Quick Trip 500. Goodbye, everyone.